I would like to have known what really happened.
So, we're gonna roll through Tenebrae.
Not before visiting the royal tomb at Kartanica.
You're sure you're up to that?
The wounds have mended. It's a matter of...
Well, at least I can get back to actually doing combat and fighting within battles and stuff like that. I don't really like the non-combative parts of this game, such as the early parts of 13, such as like the whole of Aiden fight. Titan fight was cool, but it's just, yeah. Hey, what's up, Method Gamer? You know, a lot of the things in this game, if they just would have put in an extra dungeon or an extra cutscene where you actually fight, I think it would have made the storyline better and a little bit less frustrating for different points in the game. But they did say it was one of the fastest selling Final Fantasies of all time, so... I don't know, though. To be fair, though, a lot of the other Final Fantasies, they didn't have, like, digital downloads. They didn't have as much access and promotion as this game did. I mean, back in the days of Final Fantasies 1, forget about it, 2 and 3 had like maybe one commercial you saw on Saturday morning cartoons. Final Fantasy 2 and 3, and you saw this Moogle talking some bullshit, and it didn't make any sense in relevance to the game. We didn't, because like I said, our 2 and 3 was 5 and 6. And then when we got 7, 7 picked up, but 7 didn't really have a lot of promotion. 7 had the demos. And then... I don't know, outside of all that. Eight had some pretty good promotion. But that was only because we were waiting for the next thing after 7, because 7 was so good. 9 did okay. 10 was huge because that was PlayStation 2. But like I said, none of those games had digital download. None of them had download online. You couldn't go hop on your PS2 or whatever, PS1 and download the shit. So it's pretty different now. By the time Final Fantasy X-2 came out, we had GameStops and shit. That was pretty cool. Final Fantasy 12. 13 is when it kind of started popping off. I mean, the online ones were different as well, too. Hey, what's up, Atalanta? Yeah, Chapter 13 is going to be terrible. I've already did Chapter 13 on the level 1 clear. I did it, I already beat the game with the level 1 clear. It took me about 20 hours. But this is the guide I'm putting up on YouTube and I'm breaking up in segments. Chapter 13 is shit, especially when you're level 1. Up until the point you get Equalizer Fruit, when you get all your powers back to you in Chapter 13 and you can go back camp, eat your Equalizer Fruit, which is the food that makes it so that every level difference between you and your target you're fighting, you get increased damage in terms of magic and attack. It sucks, but once you get that, shit, that's it, man. Yeah, I mean, the thing I didn't like was the whole weird thing with the ring and all that other stuff. I felt like Niflheim could have been a lot more. Like, we never really fought with the Empire ever. We only fought, like, their cronies and their little outward bases. We never actually got to experience Niflheim. The Chancellor got turned into a monster. We never really got to talk to him. Yeah, I don't know, but you're not gonna die. You're not gonna die in Chapter 13. Like, I mean, if you get hurt too much, you just heal yourself through it, and that's really about it. There's really, like, no threat of dying. If they really wanted you to make it so you have to survive, they should have disabled items. If they disabled items and then made you sneak around and shit, that would be terrifying, because if you die, you die. You can't heal yourself, but... You know, I'm rolling up in that motherfucker... I got like 99 potions, 99 this, bunch of Phoenix Downs. Okay, well, shit. We'll just have to limp through. You just limp through it. But I guess if you really want difficulty in the game, like I said, you have to put challenges on yourself, like level 1 challenge, or no magic, or no items, or just simply try to beat the game as fast as possible. Wow.
take it you visit often?
Of course. I'm proud to call to...
In the wake of the Titan.
There we go. So we don't have a food buff, so we're going to go eat food real quick. I'm trying to think here. We're going to need this one food buff will last through all this time. We're going to go back in time one more time and do another food buff. That will be the second one. And then need one for chapter 13. And then, of course, one for the final boss. So we have three. We're going to need four, so we're going to have to stock up on supplies anyway. Anyways. We'll just go ahead and... Well, actually, let's see what we got here. Are there any items I need to buy? Let's see what weapons I have. Bloodsword, no. Thunderbolt, got it. Wyvernlance, got it. Delta daggers? Yeah, but we'd rather keep them with the Assassin's Dagger because it does poison damage.
Come back.
We're going to just go ahead and go to the rest car. And we're going to go back in time and make sure we get our equalizer food. That's another thing that was pretty crazy. With the equalizer food, it makes it so that... Well, with the equalizer food, as long as they you eat it, like, that basically negates the whole level 1 challenge, kinda. Where's the bed at? There it is. Well, really not much else to this area.
We'll see you around.
Oh, there's the bed. Good, 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 good. Alright. We're gonna go ahead and call Umbra. We're going to go to Lestalem, and then we'll come back. So we'll travel to Pass, we're going to go to Lestalem by, I think, like, enough to make two more of the equalizer food. Maybe three, I don't know, just three, maybe. That should be more than enough, three. That will make sure we definitely have enough food. And then come back and knock out this dungeon, and just run all the way to the end of the game. Yeah, but like in other Final Fantasies, there were certain times they wouldn't tell you, like, this is like the last battle, or this part's about to be fucked up, or you're not gonna have this character for a while. Certain enemies would just come in, and if you didn't have the right setup, they would just whoop your ass, even if you were leveled up pretty well. Like, I could think back towards 7. 7, the second boss you fought, the Midgard Zolom early on was fucking crazy, but you're not supposed to fight him. The when you first get to Juno, the first boss there fight was pretty silly. When you go to do Vincent, if you decide to get Vincent early on in the game, or like when you're supposed to in the mansion, that boss you have to fight to get Vincent's pretty crazy. The spider after you clear through the mountains of that area of Niflheim or whatever, that's crazy. What else is pretty nuts? Let me see, what other places were crazy in 7? The demon wall, the weapons, well, not the in-game weapons, but like, you know, the weapons you had to beat to get through. There was a lot of certain bosses that you got your ass whooped, but then again, I could have just been a very bad player as well, too. You know, Final Fantasy 8 had those moments too, and 9. Well, 9, not so much. 9 was pretty straightforward, but I did level up. 10... 10, like in Final Fantasy 10, Seymour was a bastard. If you didn't respect Seymour, that, like in Final Fantasy 10, Seymour, the last summon that you're supposed to get, you end up fighting her, she was pretty crazy. Sin wasn't that bad, but then by the time I fought Sin, I was already leveled up and stuff like that before I beat the game, so. Was it Lady Unalisca in 10? I think it was Lady Unalisca. She was crazy, Seymour was crazy, the fight with Anima was crazy. Oh, 13, there were certain fights where if you didn't beat the summon quick enough, you would die. If you didn't paradigm shift quick enough, you would die. Final Fantasy, even 12-2 had segments where if you didn't do things right, you die. I didn't play 13 Returns or Final Fantasy 13-3 Lightning Returns. That was weird as shit. 12 had some bosses that would kill you straight up. 11 and 14 were MMORPGs. Yeah. Of course, you know, Final Fantasy 1 and 2 had moments where certain shit would just kill you. And then, 3 and 4 weren't too bad. Final Fantasy Mystic Quest was easy as shit, but I mean, no one liked Final Fantasy. Well, I guess some people out there might have liked Final Fantasy Mystic Quest, but for the most part, that game was absolutely terrible.
I like cup noodles as much as anyone, but I think you might like them a little too much, big guy.
There's nothing else like them. They're easy to make whenever you've got a craving, and they're delicious to boot. I'll never forget my first time.
Must have been real eye-opening after all the fine dining you did before that.
Chrono Trigger now. Chrono Trigger had moments in Chrono Trigger where, like, if you, like, you would just get your ass whooped. Like, even if you did level up, if you didn't do things right and there are certain secrets you did, like, Chrono Trigger was a good example of difficulty with, you know, actually being able to do a lot of different things.
Hey, brother. What are you after this time?
Alright, so I got three more. We're gonna buy two more.
Pleasure
I need to buy two Hauled Up Nutmegs. We need to pick up two Killer Tomatoes, and that should be more than enough food to get through the rest of the game. I'm pretty sure of it. No, just the first one. This one, which is just basically the level one challenge, and then I'm going to do a speed run to see how fast I can beat the game. I think the hardest thing in this game is to beat the game as quickly as possible, with no restrictions. I mean, I could do a restriction like level 1 playthrough, no items, but eventually I would find some gimmick and then you just exploit that gimmick, and the only difficulty at that point is, like, how much do you have to exploit that gimmick really before you beat the game? I think speedrunning is your best bet, just to get through the game as quickly as possible. That's been kind of like a theme in a lot of other Final Fantasies as well, too. Final Fantasy IX had it so that if you got to the fourth disc, by a certain amount of time, you got, like, the Queen Excalibur or the Queen's Guard, something that you give Steiner and that make him do a lot of damage. We need,
Thanks for choosing Falstar.
You know, they had little stipulations. So yeah, I think that's the best thing. Because after this, I'm going to do a run through of just how fast I can beat the game. No restrictions. Just fucking run through it. I think the only time I'm going to actually have to do a couple side quests is just basically to do the photographer quest, which give a shit ton of gil for, like, next to no work. And that's about it. Oh, and doing the behemoth quest, you know, which is to get you the chochobos. Because if you don't do that behemoth quest and you try to do the part after you use your regalia and you try to just walk around, that shit takes too long. So I'm pretty sure everybody does that quest because it's like, if you don't, I mean, that's kind of crazy, right? Let me see here. Is there a parking spot down here? No, we don't want to set that as destination. We want to fast travel here. Then we're going to go camp, eat the food, return back to the present, knock out that dungeon. But yeah, Chapter 1 goes by in a breeze. Chapter 2, going to Chapter 3, you just do the Chochobo quest real quick, then you proceed doing the main thing, Lestalem, talk to Iris, walk around, go to the extra dungeon behind the waterfall, knock that out, come back to town, go and kill Titan. Titan's pretty straightforward. After you kill Titan, you come back. I think, after Titan, yeah, you lose your regalias, and then you use your chochobos that you got, you go and touch all the places around me, you do the Ramna dungeon, you get out, go get your regalia back, come back to Lestalem, push us on the storyline, a week later, come out of there, then you drive to the next location, so you can skip past two straight-up dungeons. You don't even have to do any of the side stuff when Iris has you drive. The only thing you have to do is the one base you infiltrate when you go fight against R9 for the first time.
It's getting hot.
Then after
here. That,
the Gladios leaves the party, you fight with Glara and I, you go to that dungeon that only opens up at nighttime.
In a nice room tonight?
Yes, I'm certain we can secure.
After that, what, you get Gladio back in your party, and you come to Atissa, you kill Leviathan. After you kill Leviathan, you're pretty much in the point where I'm at, and that's just basically, you just do a bunch of half-assed train missions. That's it. And then, you know what, chapter 13, that's like the weirdest one, the longest one, where you just roll around, sneak around. But you can just run or just roll on the ground and just get through all the different areas of that quick. trying to think if there's anything else. That's pretty much about it. Well, and then you just speed through the game and knock everything out. I saw a guy speedrun the game already. He got it down within, I think, sub 6 hours. So, my first speedrun through, if I can get anything under 8, that'd be great. Well, see, that's, I don't think that's really hard because that's just platforming, right? So if you memorize the platforming, that's one thing. If you try to speed one like a level 1 playthrough or just try to... The reason why I think speedruns are so much more difficult because then you're racing against other people, and then a definition of a good speedrun is beating or getting like in a certain top level of runs, right? So let's just say the fastest speedrun in the world is 5 hours. Then things pop up like, okay, well, this is my first speedrun. Okay, now you gotta go for sub 8, then you gotta go for sub 7, then you try to get below 6 hours. You know, and then once you get to the point where you're getting like below 7 hours, then you gotta start looking up like what are the part of my runs is costing me the most time? Am I not using a glitch? Am I not using a certain technique? Am I not killing an enemy fast enough? Oh man, this boss that I'm killing him very sloppy. Then you gotta do a little research. What are they doing that I'm not doing? Okay, this is what I need to do. Because you just can't simply just level up because that wastes time. So then you have to start looking up things. Are they doing glitches? Are they doing this? What's their setup? Can I plan a better route? And then even if you do all that and you end up getting a real good time, then it's like, okay, well, now here comes the RNG of everything. I not only have to match their time, but now I have to hope that I have good RNG. Because what, there's certain fights that are determined by RNG. This fight can go, if it goes well... If these fights, all the stars align and everything go well, you'll get a good fight, which means you'll be able to actually go on a world record world pace. And then as you finally close it on that world title and you beat it, then it's like some guy discovers some glitch that shaves 5 minutes off. Now you're back to square one and you got to do all over again. I guess any time when you have to compete versus other people, even if it's just speedrunning, that's what makes the game infinitely hard because you always... When you're dealing with other people, they set the level of difficulty. You know, like StarCraft, League of Legends. Like, I really feel like the hardest games are the ones that, you know, people set, that are controlled by people, or people determine the level of difficulty, I guess is what I'm trying to say. We'll just go ahead and use the Earth. Where's what? It's Ancient Dragon 2. Stop 99, 234, and post stop cast 3 times. Sure, why not? You know, that's when the game gets real difficult. Alright, so we got everything we needed. We're gonna go ahead and camp, then we're gonna go back and then teleport back to the present, knock out this dungeon, and keep it moving. We're almost at the end. We're at 10 hours of gameplay right now, so I'd imagine we'll have the game beat with under 15 hours, which is not bad. Just for a walkthrough, or just doing it by level 1. It can probably be cut down easily.
Sounds good.
Oh, man. You probably could cut this... A level 1 speedthrough run through the game, you probably could get sub 9, sub 8, I'd imagine. But you would really have to, like, only do enough grinding so you get certain skills and only do enough of certain things... to get a certain amount of gil, because you're gonna want to use the equalizer food, because the equalizer food speeds up so much of the gameplay in the Final Fantasy 1 run through of the game. So determining how many equalizer foods you need to beat the game, when you can afford to use it and when you really don't, how you get the money to do it, because when you want to get the equalizer food recipe, you have to spend 7,000 gil. So how are you gonna get that 7,000 gil right away? And then the recipe for that, it's like, what, 24? It's about 3,500 gil to craft it. And then you got to plan, okay, well, what campsites, at what point and what campsites I use? When does my food reset? When does the game clear my food buff? You know? Then you got to think about, okay, when am I going to get the extra AP points and put into extend food time?
I need you to come with me tomorrow morning.
All that shit makes to a very difficult run. And see, that's what makes things crazy. Like, when you start planning out your routes, helping too much. When to take this food buff, when to go back in time and eat, when to not, when to sell items, what items I'm not using, what items do I need to pick up in dungeon that I can use. Why are you picking up this item? Because this gives me just enough money. If I sell this with the Titan Bangle and sell this and sell this and sell this, I'll have just enough money to buy this much shit just to move on. And then let's just say something fucks up in your game and you're like 4 hours through the speed run, right? And then something fucks up, or you take a fucked up death, or you use too many items here. Then you gotta know, like, okay, what's the backup strategy? Okay, well, I fucked up here. I used too many more Phoenix Downs than I needed, so I need to go here, which means I need to go here, and I need to pick up this to do this, to get this item to guarantee the next fight. Okay, that just added another 7 minutes on my runtime now. And then some things will just... I'm pretty sure there'll be certain segments where if you fuck it up 5 hours, 6 hours into a game, oh, there goes your whole run. Your whole run's dead. Like, Final Fantasy X is, like, I think they got it down to, like, 9 hours or 8 hours or something crazy, and that's with skipping cutscenes from what I heard. Like, that's crazy, dude. That'd be very depressing to be within the midst of an 8 or 9 hour speedrun.
More like sweltering.
And, like, you fuck up at one point, kills the whole run. But, I mean, that's part of the whole game, so yeah. I think your best bet is just to do speedruns for an RPG game. Outside of that, like you said before, Final, just... putting restrictions on yourself. Restricting yourself to what you can and can't use. I think if you did like a level 1 no item run through, that probably would be very upsetting until you figure out whatever strategy you want to do. But like at that point you're just punishing yourself, because no items and level 1, that'd be crazy. No items, a no item run would actually be pretty cool. That would actually be pretty interesting. But then again, a no item run through, you would just over level like a motherfucker, get hella powerful shit and just try to combo attack certain bosses and kill them in one hit or whatever. That, or you just dodge everything with Noctis and keep his ass alive, and you know, something like that. Oh yeah, okay, so you know what's up, Final. Yeah. RPGs are very daunting in my opinion of speedrun. It's not like Mario or Metroid or some shit. There's a lot of elements of RNG shit. Like, my favorite speedruns I watch are like Super Metroid and Mega Man, but mostly like, yeah, Mega Man, Super Metroid, those mechanical driven games, because like with Metroid it just looks all mechanical. I mean, once you know the knowledge and you know what's up, then it just comes down to execution, you know? But it is pretty sad when you see somebody about to get world record pace and then they fuck up. I remember I was watching Awesome Games Done Quick, and they have this thing, well, you probably know what it is, save the animals or kill the animals, and the guy actually would have had a world record if he didn't actually have to stop and save the animals. That was pretty hilarious. That made me laugh a lot, pretty hard. He's like, man, if I didn't have to go to those extra rooms and save the animals, I would have got a new world record for Super Metroid, which is really incredible, because that game's been out for how long and how many people speedrun that shit? Yeah. Plus, it's a very competitive game, just like Super Mario 64. That would be very depressing. Alright, so, we're gonna go ahead and knock out this next dungeon. We got our equalizer food, we got plenty of magic. There's really nothing to invest into Ascension anymore. I mean, the main thing we got the level 99 skill where it boosts the food of our meals eaten at camp. We got all our double accessories. We don't need nothing in the teamwork. I mean, we can get boost link strike damage, but let's just be honest, it really doesn't help. So I probably might put some points in there. We got the main combat skills that we need, but like, we don't need anything else per se. We really don't. Level 1, 100% completion? Yep. As long as you use your equalizer food, that shouldn't be too difficult at all. The only thing that might be fucking weird is the, what is it called? When you get to level 1, and, or when you do your level 1 run through, and you actually end up, going to the no item dungeon. Level 1 no item dungeon would probably be the most difficult, because for the most time I see it, when they do the no item dungeon, Well, I guess it wouldn't be that bad. You would just go in, clear a set of monsters, leave, reheal, do whatever you gotta do, go back in and do that until you get to the final boss. The hardest part would be the final boss. You would need one other character to stay alive, and then you just sit back and dodge everything, and then you just have them just do their little tech abilities or whatever. I don't think it'd be too bad, but it would be. It would definitely be interesting. We should be able to run through this pretty quickly.
In this environment. Mind we don't end up prey.
Right. Good tip.
Footing's bad. Watch your step.
Oh yeah, plus we can't use Overwhelm anymore. So pretty much that's it. Overwhelm carried so hard in the beginning settings for the bosses and stuff like that. Because now he got like Libra or whatever, that whatever ability that he has that scans targets and shit. Which is really, in my opinion, not that great. Because I assume, I guess, you could only use Overwhelm in the past when he actually had his vision, which is weird, but, I mean, it is what it is. But Overwhelm, man, that skill is amazing. If I had that skill versus Ravis fight, it probably would make the Ravis fight or the fight the last boss in Chapter 13 would make him a joke. It probably would actually make Ifrit, and it also would make... It would make Ifrit a joke as well, too, so I guess that's why they make it so he can't use it anymore. Yeah, you can switch back to Overwhelm, but unfortunately, it doesn't work for me when I use it. Oh, use it on Ifrit? Maybe it just has to be on Chapter 14, then. Or maybe I'm just crazy. Because when I went back through it again, I couldn't use it. Or maybe, like I said, maybe I fucked up. No, I believe you, Biggs. I believe you. Maybe I'm just saying maybe I fucked up or something.
Hey, you should hang back.
Was I in the way?
No, you weren't. It's just...
There's also sometimes it's fucked up where if your characters are misplaced, you can't do certain skills or techniques, but even on the last fight, I just basically threw all my damage on Prompto, and Prompto just fucking just popped off shots until that, in between me casting magic on Ifrit, and then they just all died pretty horribly.
Right.
Did you like the ending, Biggs? I enjoyed it. It was pretty nice. Okay, that's what it was, yeah. Yeah, okay, I know I wasn't going crazy. For him, it was just a slugfest. You just put on your assassin's dagger, you just wail at him. I mean, on that fight, I just used Prompto. Prompto was popping off, as I say. I just stacked Prompto with two strength accessories and his best weapons that he could use and just had him pop off. Or was it Prompto? Maybe it was Gladio. I don't know. It's just a long-ass fight no matter what you do, so you just kind of just deal with it, unfortunately. You're like, well, this fight's going to take forever. As long as I got 99 potions and about 15 Phoenix Downs, I should be fine. But then again, I never used any magic boost or anything like that before him, so I might need to do that as well. The ending was really cool. It made me sad because they really could have built upon the storyline mode to make it a lot better.
Let's see.
Yeah, it could be that, you know, Ravis or whatever his name is, Ravis, maybe physical damage is the way to go. I'll use a damage booster versus him at least one or two, but
I am really not
looking forward to Chapter 13. Like, I'm actually getting the shakes right now. That's how much I hate that chapter. I do not want to do that shit no more. Like, I'm tired. I'm an old man. I ain't got time for no walking around sneaking and shit. You know, I'm tired. I don't want to do that no more. You know, I'm really dreading doing that shit again. I hate Chapter 13 with the passion. And as you know, Suus, chapter 13, when you're level 1, that shit takes so long to drain and kill those monsters. I'm like, what kind of shit is this? It's like the game is punishing you. I was a sad black man. People gonna ask me that, well, Debo, why are you so sad? I'm doing chapter 13, level 1 challenge. Sorry about that, buddy. I'm like, I know, I'm so sad right now. Sad black man. You'll see me on the corner of the bus stop just sitting there looking really sad. What's sad, Debo? Why are you so sad? Are you sad about the injustices facing black people? Nah, I'm doing a level 1 challenge in Final Fantasy 15. And, it's taking a lot longer than I'd hope. What the fuck is Final Fantasy 15, nigga? It's a video game on the PlayStation 4. Oh, you mean like Madden? No, it's not like Madden. You know what? Yeah, sure, it's like Madden. Whatever makes you understand what I'm going through. So what you mad, man? You put some money on some Madden, you lost some? Yeah, man, you know what? Just never mind. Never mind. You ever played Final Fantasy, dog? Nah, man, I ain't fuck with no fantasy, nigga. I'm only dealing with real life. He takes out a gun, he's like, look. As long as I got my 9, I got my liquor, and my Madden, I'm alright. Like, where do you get this shit from? Who just takes out a gun like that? Oh, that's right. We live in America. Oh, man. Oh. Alright. Y'all gotta die. I ain't got time for this. I ain't got time for that. Am I dead yet? Come on, Gladio. Oh, wait a minute. Gladio's not here. He's behind me. There we go. Well, I got through all the hard part during the daylight. Sometimes if you don't do this dungeon right and it gets dark at night, you get turned around, but I was able to knock out most of the stuff. Back by the control panel. Then let's go. And then since we got the food equalizer, it makes this whole dungeon a real joke, since our level difference is so much different. And then plus that, on top of all that, I got strong magic. Plus I got the extended time on the camp food buff before we came here, so... Is my squad here? Yeah, they're here. There we go. All right. That's it. I will enjoy the speed run of this game, because I definitely do miss using the skills that give me more damage based on my level and stuff. Level 1 playthrough, most of the stats you get from the tree are utterly useless. Gladio stay carrying, doing all that big man damage. He's a big man.
Right here.
How does it look?
She's wired and ready. Give it
Come
a go.
Now. Come
then
on.
Don't
now.
Blow it up.
Oh, thanks for the advice.
There we go.
Did it work?
Yep. One more to go.
What the fuck is it dead? Okay, it is dead. I was about to be like, that shit ain't dead. I just killed it. All right.
For long, though. Hurry up and move the machine.
Yes, sir.
Ooh, I can't walk down those stairs. There we go.
Yeah, so much for sticking together.
I really don't like Gladios' attitude in the last couple chapters. Alright, now we can go fight the Marlboro. Which probably is gonna die very quickly, I'd imagine.
Did you hear that?
Between the magics and the autos with the poison and shit like that, I can't imagine it's gonna take much to kill him. How much magic do I got, though? I got 2 casts on 194, I got 15, 224s, 252, 7, and 234, 3. So yeah, we're good. That is probably more than enough magic to get to the game. I probably need to craft one set of magic versus Ifrit, though, because I'm going to need lightning and ice. I can't use fire, because I don't want it to pop off. Well, I can use enough fire to give enough potency, but I can't make it a triple cast or whatever. It has to only be able to cast Blizzaga and, like, lightning or whatever. It can't cast fire. It just won't do no damage to him. Or I think it actually heals him. I forget which, and I don't want to heal that motherfucker. Come on now. That's it. Okay.
These tombs are always in the darnest places.
Glad you're taking this seriously. Going it alone, huh? Hold up.
Here goes Gladios' speech.
You sure you're ready for this?
Yep.
You got what it takes.
To do what?
To face your answer.
And I can't even
sisters and convince them to lend you their strength. Got a long road ahead. Can you see this through to the end?
Can and will, whether I like it or not, I've got a duty to fulfill as king.
You're damn right you do. Then that means you'd better start taking this seriously.
Yeah, he does. If it wasn't for his ability to carry and do so much damage and get parties, I would really hate him. I mean, I still like him. I understand he has to make Noctis not be a bitch, but... I guess it annoys me when I just want to be able to skip the cutscene and move on. So I got, what, one cast of 194, 252, dual cast, 2 chain 99. We'll probably use that. We'll just equip that real quick and I'll equip back. Just want to pop off and kill this shit real fast.
Not what I said.
Well, the summons are there, but I agree with you. I guess it's okay because the summons, when they do show up, they kill everything, literally, so... We gotta fight Marlboro.
Let's get on with it.
Between the spellcast Oranger, he's gonna probably die very quickly.
I hate eggs.
But I'm okay with the lack of summons because when the summons do show up, they kill everything. But not being able to summon them, I can understand that's a little frustration of some people. Oh, apparently I can't move. We'll have to wait. I must have mixed my magic wrong. Funny enough, this has happened before in this boss before. Now we're all just sitting here wondering what the fuck just happened. There we go.
Ching. Bust him up.
Damn, I can't even use my Oranger. Come on now. Don't be a dick. Ah, fucked up again. Well, he's almost dead anyway. I guess I don't need to use it, right? The summons just, I'll tell you, they kill everything regardless. In my experience in playing, every time I've gotten it, everything's died. Well, every time I got it, everything died. But see, I had equalizer food on. If you have equalizer food on, it doesn't make a difference. Like, I kill shit faster doing the level 1 playthrough with equalizer food, which basically makes it so, you know, you do more damage based on between the level of difference between you and your target. I haven't had any problems. But it's not dead. Okay, it's dead.
Yeah. Is it dead?
It is.
Whisking them just makes a mess. Better fry them.
I think we found it.
Just wish they found a better place to build it.
Yeah, eat one equalizer food and see what happens. It's a $7,000 item from the Stalem, from the left food vendor behind the hotel. Then you get the recipe. The recipe of the camp with it only costs 3,500. Gives you 1,000 HP, like 300 fucking attack, and it also gives you increased damage based on the level difference between you and your target. So the higher the level, the more damage you do, apparently, or whatever. That's what people were using to do the high-end dungeons with level 1 challenge, right, or be animated twice at level 1.
Yeah, let's.
Okay, that was it. Skip that cutscene when Ignis makes his moral boosting or whatever speech. So I think that's it for chapter 9. Then we should be moving into chapter 10 and 11. Then knock out 12, then we'll be in 13. Well, I mean, yeah, that's the whole point. Like, me, I just use the equalizer, so I said, fuck it, I'm gonna use it, right? Because then it's like, the way I thought about not using equalizer, right? But if you do the level 1 playthrough, then all it comes down to is that if you don't use equalizer food, it's just using assassin's daggers, right? To slowly kill it off with poison? So there is no difference. The only thing that equalizer does for the level 1 playthrough, it speeds you up through the bullshit. You know, it's, like I said, like, anything that's difficult in this game can be dealt with by just having a lot of items. So, like, the only way I could see it being really hard is if you did something along the lines of, hey, we're not only gonna do the level one challenge, but we're also maybe level one challenge, no AP. But then you can still use Equalizer Fuel. Okay, so what, level one challenge, no AP usage, no item usage? I could see that being pretty crazy. But even then, if you found a system to beat the game without using the Equalizer Food, using a level one challenge stipulation and not using any AP, I think what it would just come down to is you using Assassin's Daggers and then just dodging everything and just trying to put poison on them. And it, at that point, it's just trial and error. I mean, it would probably take a while, but once you get the understanding of the game down, it's that's it, you know? Yeah, you could do that as well, too. Stack the magic accessories. So, like I said, I think if you really want difficulty in this game, your best bet is just to do a speed run. All right, that's it. So that ends Chapter 10. If you're on YouTube watching this video is going to cut off right here. If you're in the stream, we're going to keep going on because we got to knock out these chapters. So that's Chapter 10 down. 11 and 12 go by very quickly, and then we go